It was a manic Sunday in the IPL. I mean, apart from the fact that it was a double header, which has its own excitement, two matches in the same day. But to have both matches going into the super over, and then the second match not just going into a super over, going into two super overs, is, you know, I mean, it just drove everybody nuts in a delightful way, because where do you get to see such action, such heart-stopping, such a heart-stopping contest where things are decided not in regulation time, but of the last ball perhaps of the super over and stuff like that. So a terrific day for T20 fans, and certainly fans of the Indian Premier League. Let's just look at what happened in the first match. Sunrisers Hyderabad versus KKR. It looked like KKR hadn't got enough runs, 163 on the board, but the pitch was slowing down. Then of course Sunrisers Hyderabad seemed to lose their way. Hit a little by Williamson's injury, he opened the innings, actually did a decent job. Warner batting lower in the order, trying to take on the responsibility of finishing the match. It didn't quite happen. I thought KKR, I mean, you know, Lockie Ferguson, what a match for him. The first delivery, he gets a wicket. He's playing his first match in the tournament. Ends up with 3 for 15 of his 4 overs, and then in the super over, takes 2 wickets, including Warner bowled for a blob. I mean, he was the danger man, Warner. So, I mean, this was out of, believe it or not, please believe it or not. In fact, I tweeted to the KKR franchise on the handle and to Shah Rukh Khan, the owner, and I said, you know, this kind of heroism deserves a movie from his company, which makes movies, Red Chillies. And then they replied, they asked me, what would this movie be called? I said, you can call it Lockie Mera Naam. So, but that was just fun. But terrific match, and what it's done is it's kind of given, you know, wing to KKR's aspirations. Hyderabad now struggling badly. A week back, they looked the best of the middle teams, you know, after Delhi and Mumbai, they looked the best of the lot. Now, of course, even RCB have gone ahead after that spectacular knock from AB de Villiers, but languishing now, Hyderabad, along with Chennai Super Kings, Rajasthan Royals, and Kings XI Punjab. So that's how cruel this format can be. The second match, Mumbai versus Punjab. Now this is, you know, I want to highlight this, that Mumbai is the top ranked team in the tables, most points. Punjab at that point in time, now they've gone up to number 6, but Punjab was bottom of the table. So in, you know, in most leagues across the world, not cricket leagues, but any other sport, there would be a complete mismatch between the top team and the bottom team. You know, and here in the IPL, the great thing is that all 8 teams actually have a fairly, they're fairly evenly matched. It's just that teams which perform better on that day have stronger nerves, win crux situations, find a player who can put his hand up and win the match, they end up winning. So in the case of Punjab, what we've seen throughout the season is that they were a good team, but very top heavy. Rahul, Mayank Agarwal getting the runs. Now there's Gail. Puran is also adding some heft. And, you know, bowling was very good with Shami, Ashwin, M. Ashwin, Ravi Bishnoi, not bad at all. But not doing, you know, not kind of sustained excellence. And that's why they were languishing. Of the matches that they've lost, they should have won 3, in my opinion. They lost such close encounters because they didn't have the... What I said, you have to have the guts to win also. They just seemed to lose the gut when it came to winning the match. And here was Mumbai. This was a contest which could have finished off Kings XI's, Punjab's aspirations in this tournament had they lost. Now they were actually in, you know, on oxygen. Now they've pulled themselves off from the ventilator and they're back in action. But they need to, you know, go further ahead. However, what they did with Bombay is, or Mumbai, Mumbai pulled themselves to a good score through obviously their, you know, Pollard and Nathan Coulter-Nile. And then it went into the super over. Then, you know, again, I thought that Punjab had lost their nerve, just not happening. And then somehow they managed to tie that super over, and then the second super over. And that's where I think, you know, experience comes into the fore. The way Shami bowled, his international experience, his experience of so many of these players, because he plays against them so often, or has, you know, over the many years. And he bowled an absolutely fantastic over. And then it was a... In the first two, and then of course there was Chris Gayle coming and hitting Kent Bolt first ball for a 6. That kind of completely dissipated the pressure around around Punjab, and Chris Gayle has seen many a battle, so he knows what is to be done. That's where they benefited. But overall, what a great Sunday for cricket fans. Two super over matches, in fact the second going into two super overs, so it's a three super overs on one day, unprecedented. It can only happen in the T20 format, and certainly I think it's only happened so far in the IPL.